recording sessions for this second Subterranean Disposition album. The soundtracks for our Landscapes of Failure began in December of 2004, last year. Basically, I'd been able to recruit Dan Nahum from Australian bands such as The Veil and Dead River Runs Dry to perform on the album and collaborate with me. And he'd been listening to the demo tracks for probably about a year, and came down to Melbourne, and within a 4-day period we rehearsed for 2 days, so that was the only time we had to physically learn the material, and then 2 days of recording here at Toyland Studios. And it was a whirlwind week of creativity and quick thinking on your feet, and Dan is an exceptional drummer and intelligent musician, and between the pair of us we nutted out all the arrangements, and big credit to Dan for being able to interpret and play this material in such a small amount of time and add such a solid foundation for me to go off. Slight things would change from the demo and only enhance the music, and I would add little things where he had performed different fills and different stuff, and just versatility. There was brushwork, cymbal work, and then obviously double kick playing, extreme metal playing and stuff, so there's a whole range of dynamics that Dan has brought to this record. A little bit over the top, but I like where it kind of
too much. Yeah,
just maybe just a. We'll be right back. So after the first self-titled Subterranean album, a lot of people had picked up on the use of saxophone in the song called Most Subtle of Storms, and I felt like it was an success to add sort of a foreign instrument like that into the mix. And looking at some of the demos, I began to wonder if they too could have some saxophone in it. And as time went on in between then and now, I basically came into a position where I was able to borrow someone's saxophone and have the time to start learning how to play the instrument, which I've wanted to do for probably about 5 or 6 years. And I was very headstrong that I was going to play some saxophone on the album. In hindsight, I was probably a bit green and went behind the ears, but I think, you know, you only learn by putting yourself under the microscope, and I think I've been able to add to at least 2 of these tracks with some saxophone, so it was really cool to do something new as a musician. Sound off, don't they? Or maybe it all sounds off. This time around, with some of the guitars, in particular the clean guitars, I wanted to get a specific sound. So I was lucky enough to be able to call on a longtime friend and bandmate from a few bands that we've been in together, such as The Eternal, Cryptic Darkness, and Insomnium Dei. Mr. Mark Kelson, he's got his own studio now called Kelsonic Studios. And yeah, I was lucky enough to go down there for an afternoon and play around on a couple of his lovely guitars. He has a lovely Strat and a lovely Telecaster, and we were able to sculpt out some really good sounds in some of the ambient passages that these songs have. I guess the label we were sort of joking around with was post-apocalyptic Americana sort of sounds, so we had a bit of, I guess you could say, folk or country twang to some of the really open, clean guitars, which was what I was going for all along. Another collaborator that I was very fortunate to have come in on this album is a very talented lady called Galare Paul. She's an Iranian-born, Melbourne-based musician, and I asked her if she would collaborate and perform some music on this track called Embedded. She plays the Comanche and the Quanchek, and she's got some mighty big lungs on her too, some amazing singing, and she came down one afternoon and performed on this track Embedded, and basically just blew me away, and I think she was stepping outside, not so much her comfort zone, but stepping outside her usual way of performing as she's a singer-songwriter, and she was able to just come up with some magical things that enhanced 2 key areas of this song, and just really brought the tale to life. And she sings in native tongue of Farsi, and it's just some otherworldly sounds going on, and I'm just deeply honoured and deeply grateful that she was willing to experiment and do some stuff on this record. Recording music here at Toyland Studios with Adam Kalaitzis since 1999, so basically over 16 years of coming in and doing albums with various other projects. Obviously Subterranean did the first album in 2012, and being a one-man band is a very daunting thing to come in and lay down pretty much everything, and sometimes objectivity gets thrown out the window when you're so caught up in the performance side of tracking music. And Adam's always been a good sounding board for things that either sound good or don't, or even just different ideas approaching stuff. There's always been little nuances that can get highlighted and improved in the recording situation. As far as bringing the music to life in a mix, it's always been, you think of like being a kid in a candy store. It's just like come in and get surprised. I guess like every time I come in, I try to bring something new and see how I've evolved since the last time I've recorded. And Adam is no different with his craft. He's always finding new ways to put something together and make it, make that magic happen. So very grateful to 15, 16 years down the track, still be coming in here, and I think we're doing some of the best stuff that I've done personally, music-wise, and it's just been blown up to this huge, massive thing with the aid of his magic mixing and just studio mastering.
Sounds really good.